My name is Robert Malone. I'm a physician scientist. I'm licensed to practice in the state of Maryland, USA. I graduated from Northwestern Medical School in Chicago, here in the USA, which is one of the top schools. With my MD, I got my Bachelor's of Science in Biochemistry from UC Davis, another excellent program. I got a Master's degree in Biology in lieu of a PhD from UC San Diego and the Salk Institute, where I was working in the molecular biology and virology labs when I made these discoveries that led to the 9 patents that are issued. They were all filed in 1989. I completed 2 postdoctoral fellowships that were funded, as well as extensive postgraduate training at Harvard University School of Medicine, having to do with global clinical research. I've been involved in vaccine development for about 30 years, often very closely with the U.S. government, and most closely with the Defense Threat Reduction Agency. I've been working on COVID since I got a call from a CIA officer who was in Wuhan on January 4th that told me to get my team spun up. At the time, we were focused on developing novel compounds as treatments for organophosphate poisoning, whether through pesticides or through biowarfare agents. And turned that team, we volunteered and focused on repurposing drugs for COVID. Out of that came the discovery of famotidine, and more recently, the combination of famotidine and celecoxib. Here in the States, we would call that Pepcid and Celebrex. Those clinical trials are about to launch, if they haven't already launched this week, under funding from DOD. I was at the tip of the spear in bringing forward the Ebola vaccine that was originally developed by Public Health Agency Canada, and got Merck involved. That's now the licensed Merck Ebola vaccine. I was in charge of about $150 million of a $300 million contract for development of a cell-based influenza vaccine for Solvay. I worked for the Global Aris Global TB Vaccine Foundation in the past. I've won over, many billions of dollars, in grants and contracts with the U.S. government for development of vaccines and biologics. I used to work directly for the Department of Defense for clinical research on virtually all of their biodefense products. I commonly sit on study sections, often as study section chair, for the NIH for vaccine contracts that are in the range of $80 to $150 million. So this is, I'm a specialist in vaccines and drug repurposing, regulatory affairs, clinical development, project management, grants and contracts, etc.
So the key question is, you're not an anti-vaxxer. You're someone who has been intimately involved with the vaccinations. You're not a crank. You're a scientist.
I hate to listen to. Yeah, I hate that the word anti-vaxxer is something that has been developed by the media to basically gaslight people. True. And it's interesting that Webster's somehow has, it's much like my Wikipedia being scrubbed by literally the same guys that have removed any reference to ivermectin as a therapeutic. It is the same editor that's done that for some reason. But, this is the way things are in this modern age, where we have investment groups actively modifying information. We can call it censorship and propaganda, I think, is the simple way to put it. And
that's right.
It's hard for the public to figure out what's truth and what isn't truth, because the truth is so heavily managed.